On election night, when we're all done with voting, the precinct clerk will let us know that we can start packing up. The very first thing that we do is we go to the back of the ICE unit. We check the auxiliary bin for any unscanned ballots that may have been put into it during the day. There are no unscanned ballots, which is a good thing. We will take out the unscanned ballot envelope. We will need that later. We then use the security token to talk to the machine. We'll use the username and password that we were provided. We are going to select close poll. We're going to select close. We put in the password we were provided again and hit OK. We're confirming that we want to close the poll. We get a warning message and a flashing red light. This reminds us that we go back to the back of the machine and double check to make sure there are no unscanned ballots in the auxiliary bin. After we've unlocked the bin and looked in one more time, we come back and we hit OK. There's nothing in there. And now it's printing the results tape. When the results tape is done printing, we are going to have this signed by the precinct clerk, the assistant precinct clerk, the clerk EVID operator, and the voting equipment specialist. At this point, we are going to tear off the tape, and we are going to select yes, that we do want a second copy. The second copy of the results tape will not be signed. We will tear this off, and this gets taped to the outside door of the polling room in accordance with Florida election laws. We'll tear off that tape. And again, that remains unsigned and gets taped to the outside door. After that, we do not want an additional copy. Then we proceed to transmitting the results. So now what we're going to do is we are going to remove the USB cable for the external monitor and just set that aside. We are going to go back into the auxiliary bag. We saw this at the beginning of the day when we started up. Inside of the patch, inside of that bag, is the USB air card. We open this up and put this into the USB port where we just unplugged the monitor. You'll see the red light come on. At this point, we are going to select results transfer. We're going to hit start. We'll put in our password that we're provided. We select yes, start the results transfer. And when we do this, we stand here by the machine and wait. This may take a little while. It's going to detect the modem that we just plugged in. And then we want to watch all the screens go by and make sure the results did transfer successfully. Sometimes you might be at a precinct where connectivity isn't all that good and you may need to try to do this a second time. If after two attempts the results do not transfer, you let your precinct clerk know and they will let our office know. And we have a secondary plan to get the results brought over to us at our Brooksville office immediately. We'll see that the connection was established. And this is one of the errors that we can see, that if it doesn't transmit the first time, we're going to retry it. So after the results transmit, it will print off a report saying that the results transmitted successfully. We'll tear that report off and save that, and that comes back to us. We do not need a second copy. And then we begin powering down the ICE unit. So the first thing we do is we hit the power button in the top right-hand corner of the screen. Then we hit shutdown. And once the unit shuts down, we will remove the USB air card from the side of the machine, and we will add this to the pile of things that goes back to the precinct clerk. The next thing we will do is we'll close the privacy screen and then lower the screen for the unit. After that, we get to pack up all the ballots from the day. From here, we go back into the ballot bin. We unlock the ballot bin. On election day, this will be full of ballots, and you can use assistance from other election workers to help you take out all of the ballots and then stack them neatly. They just have to be in the same orientation. It doesn't matter which way they're facing. And then we neatly stack them into the ballot bag. Once that's done, we are going to unseal the write-in bin, lift up the little white door, and then all of the write-in ballots will be accessible here. Some of them will fall out, others we will have to reach in and grab the write-in ballots. When we have all those ballots out, we close the door, and then we will put the write-in ballots into the write-in ballot envelope, which is in the VES yellow file. At this point, we will take the monitor, put this back into the bag, close it, and then close the ballot box door. On election night, we would then cut off the yellow seal here, lift up the port door, and we would remove the memory card. That would also be returned to us on election night. And after this, we just pack up the ICE unit. We would unplug the cable, the power cable. And neatly wind it up into the cable port in the back of the machine. And then close the door. We will then pack up the units from the accessible voting booth. Take the headphones out. Put them back neatly into the bag, along with the headphone protectors and the USB cable. Zip the bag closed, put that back on the ICE unit. The next thing we will do is we will neatly wind up the ATI, audio tactile interface. And this gets Velcroed into place for shipping. Next, we're going to take down the light pole. We unplug the light pole, separate this into two pieces. If you have a Velcro strap that's provided, you can use that to put around the cable. The smaller end goes in the bottom first. The top has a bracket that will rest on the lower one. You take the clip and put that into place. Next, we go back and get our lid. Make sure this is in place. Sometimes when we put these on, these little ears will be on the outside, which will prohibit us from locking it. So we want to make sure that the ears are inside of the grooves on both sides. We lock the lid on both sides, and we're ready to go.